So can you tell me a little bit about how you're involved in the creative arts in Teesside?
Well, I started about 1997. I'm that old. As part of a night class, and because a friend of mine was doing night class, so I was doing a different one completely. And during a tea break, I went to say hello, and they said, "Oh, here, just fiddle on this guy." And I was like, no, I can't. I don't. I'll just ruin your painting and all that. And he said, "Oh, no, come on, you know, just give it, you can't, it's acrylic, I'll just go over it. There's no, so I was like very hesitantly just putting a few dots on, and I was like, and to cut a long story short, the following September, I joined the same night class doing painting. I never thought I would. I did photography a bit when I was at school, but it's very different, as you know, from painting. And so it was good to start. I thought, well, nobody knows me here in the class, obviously besides my friend, and what can I do? I can't make a mess of it and all that sort of stuff. I'll simply not show it to anyone ever again.
Fantastic. And where was that class?
In Hartlepool. It was a night class at English Martyrs Sixth Form College. It was just for amateur artists. The tutor, Roy Carlos, he's since done the Sky Arts Landscape Artist of the Year. He's been on that two or three times over the time of the program. And he was great. He just said, you know, bring a photo, do whatever you want, and he went round and helped as appropriate. It wasn't, okay, today we're learning how to do this, or today we're learning how to do that. It wasn't very structured in that way, but he's just able to let people just get on with it and do what they want, and he was able to help everyone accordingly. So the first painting I did took, I think, probably a whole semester. That was his joke. He said, painting by the end of by Christmas or your money back type thing. But needless to say, I've picked up the pace, and I paid a lot bigger, faster, I think better over the years. So that was started a very late beginner and through just a night class. And I continued for quite a few years after that, you know, after I already knew everything and all that, because it was great. The 2 hours of my time. And it doesn't matter what happened out in the world or at home or anywhere at work, all that sort of stuff. I had 2 hours of just disappeared, I guess, into the paintings, and of course the social element of it all was great, and we've remained friends ever since. So that was great.
Absolutely, I think that idea of providing space for yourself through art is really important. So I don't do much for myself. I always I'm kind of busy, but I think without taking yourself out into something, whatever your interest is, life can get a bit too, you get lost, overwhelmed in it. And it's brilliant that you've found that space for yourself. So is it mainly landscapes that you paint?
Yeah. I don't think I'm skilled enough to in portraiture. I've done a few portraits. Not sure they look so much like like the people they're supposed to, but for me, landscapes is the main thing that I've ended up doing. I've done some life drawing as well in I forgot what it's called in Middlesbrough. There's the school, not a school, it was a church. So there were a few years back, there was some night class for life drawing, and also I think I've done a few times at MIMA they've done, and that was great. It was a clothes model at MIMA, but in Linthorpe, that's the place, is Acklam. I digress. So I've done that, but mainly for me it's landscapes, and I've ventured more into now doing more painting outdoors. And I've just written a blog about that, because I found it when I first did it, it was very, very scary as to what do you do, what do you take, what don't you take. It's so very different from the act from painting inside, where you have, if let's say if you have a photo or whatever, and things don't move, and where when you paint outside, things move, and especially here and with the winds and stuff like that, everything moves very fast. The clouds change, light changes. Obviously, the buildings don't move, but everything else around it does. And of course, if the clouds affect the lighting, and then the cloud suddenly isn't there when you're busy working on that, and what do you do, and all that sort of stuff. So there's lots and lots of decisions to make and all that. So I've written a little blog about that on the website. Well,
that's really interesting. I have to get those details off you. I'm not a visual artist at all, so I hadn't really thought about that. That's great. It's really exciting. So how do you choose where you're going to go and paint?
In a way, it doesn't really matter where you go. You don't have to go out to the Himalayas or anything like that, or anything exotic. You can find beauty in wherever you go. And Teesside is a great place in the northeast as well, and Yorkshire, North Yorkshire. And so you don't have to go very far to get, especially now there's with the moorland scenes and all the purple heather and everything. It's absolutely gorgeous. For me, one of the good things about painting is you can, in comparison to photography, which it's a bit more difficult, is you can move trees if you want to, or you can move a rock if it doesn't fit the composition or what you think should go where. You can just move it. So I take inspiration by nature. I don't feverishly copy it. There's behind me. I don't know if you can see this.
That's on your door.
So that's our door to the facilities.
Fantastic.
My husband, because I was complaining that I don't have anywhere to hang any of my paintings and things like that, and we had to replace the doors, and so they were all just plain wood. And he said, "Oh, well, why don't you try on the to paint on the door?" I'm like, because my paintings up to there, you know, they haven't been that massive, and of course it's the size of a door. What am I going to do? So I took the plunge, so to speak, and High Force is an absolute beauty and appropriate in terms of the composition to get all the water flow down. So I've painted the door, and that's the.
That's brilliant. It's a great thing about being a grown up and having your own house, I suppose. You can just think, I'm going to paint the door.
I know. If we ever move, I don't know what I'm going to end up having to take the door.
Definitely.
hope the new owners like my style of painting.
Okay, so it's quite interesting to, like, obviously you found a meaningful outlet for yourself through the creative arts. So just interested in why do you think that the creative arts are important to you specifically, but to the arts more generally?
I think for me specifically, it's helped in terms of mood and being able to, I'll say, disappear. I don't literally, you know, obviously not literally, and into the whatever it is that you're doing, whatever media you choose to use, and there's whether you're very specific and detailed about if you do paintings or whatever, or whether you do sculpture or what, it just you can't, or I find I can't worry about life and everything out there when I'm focus on the painting or whatever, you know, even if it's a sculpture, photography, because my head can't do the two things at the same time. So by doing the art, it takes me out of it, out of my worrying, and I'm a worrier by my nature. So it's always been very useful for me to be able to do that, to take myself out of it. And also it's very joyful for me to be able to do it. I don't normally, even if I'm in a down mood, I don't normally, don't think do very down sort of paintings. They're very, I don't know if you can see this, I've done some examples that I've ended up doing on magnets, but they're very bright colors. And I try and look at the brightness of it all, and that helps me also with my moods and things like that. And I would implore anyone to really try, and it doesn't matter that whether you're good or not I don't think it's a real concept. The important thing for me is that you enjoy what you're doing and that you're able to de-stress, I guess. And don't worry about the fact that you're not in your head a master painter. All painters, I think, or an artist, always struggle with what they're doing, and it's never good enough, and that's why they do the next one and the next one and the next one. You never know when to stop. You never know when you're full of self-doubts and all that sort of stuff. So any person just starting or wanting an outlet, just have a go with it. And it takes, like everything, it takes time in terms of developing your skills. So initially it takes a long time, and you do very exact, or I ended up doing very exact paintings, and they took forever, to months and months to do one painting. And where I can now paint a door in a day type. So because you learn your skills, you learn your craft, you learn what works, what doesn't work, and all that. And that takes time. And don't worry about it. Everyone has that.
Brilliant. That's fantastic advice. Thanks very much for that. I suppose we're going to have to do the lockdown question. I guess for you, it's perhaps lockdown hasn't affected your practice too much.
Well, it has, because in terms of going out and things like that, and shielding and all that fun stuff, and having a family at home, it's been challenging, but it's enabled us also to, I've ended up developing a website, and so because the shops were all shut, and so in terms of trying to sell products or items of your work, it's very difficult. So we've taken the time to develop a website and start blogging. I never thought I could blog, or never thought I had anything interesting to say that anyone would might read, and so I've taken the plunge. So it's been an opportunity for me whilst trying to maintain sanity, I guess, and avoiding well, there's a lot of human contact that you avoid. You obviously can't go to your night classes or any other meetings that you wanted to do and stuff like that, and painting outside is more challenging and things like that. So we've ended up doing a whole range of items and what have you, and developing new things. So so this is a glass coaster of one of my that's paintings. Good. Don't know if you can see that.
Yeah, it's lovely.
On the reclaimed glass. It was a shop front at some point. And now it's a coaster, and things like that, and doing. We've ended up I don't know if you can. So chopping boards and of my paintings, and so and then just keep busy and try and look at other opportunities and other ways of doing things that you would normally have done and that you used to doing and used to going to galleries and having exhibitions in that way. And now trying to do products instead, or in addition, I guess, until things get back to the new normal, as
we keep being told. It's been absolutely lovely talking to you.
Thank you. And you?
I know about your practice and how it's developed over the years. And
thank you.
You've got some lovely work there, and I think it's brilliant that you've painted a door in your house. And,
Yes,
an artifact for years to come. I can just see if you ever move, having to take it from house to house.
Yeah.
All right. Well, take care, and good luck, and we'll see you hopefully in person post-lockdown.
Indeed, it was nice meeting you.
Toodaloo pip.
But I hope everyone's okay.
Brilliant. We are just about hanging in there.